When it comes to stopping pollution by reducing dependency on internal combustion engine vehicles, India is far from behind anyone in the list of countries with the most number of vehicles too. So what is the problem? Let's decode. So first, the initial cost of owning an electric vehicle is higher than the conventional automobiles in India. Secondly, the infrastructure is one issue that is further suppressing the sales of electric vehicles in India. And thirdly, electric vehicles are relatively new in terms of technology, and any new thing takes time to penetrate in society. While we've got some good news for you. So to encourage the penetration of electric vehicles in the country, the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has issued a notification to exempt battery-operated vehicles from the payment of fees for issue or renewal of registration certificate. Yes, so in a statement, the ministry said it has also exempted battery-operated vehicles from the payment of fees for the assignment of new registration marks. This has been notified to encourage e-mobility, it added. While apart from this initiative, the central government is putting efforts by offering subsidies under the FAME II scheme. In fact, the state governments are also further helping buyers by offering additional benefits. So to tell you, FAME is a policy by the Department of Heavy Industries and is an acronym for faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electric vehicles in India. So let's take a look at some of the incentives under the FAME II scheme by the central government if you want to buy any electric vehicles. First, for two-wheelers. So rupees 15,000 per kWh of battery capacity and maximum of up to 40% of the vehicle cost is subsidized. While for four-wheelers, 10,000 kWh of battery capacity, while the maximum limit is up to 1.5 lakhs, is subsidized. Further, there are schemes by the Ministry of Finance to ease the burden of owning an EV, while these schemes are not under FAME II. So all EVs are currently subjected to a lower rate of goods and services tax, that is GST, at 5% only. While the first-time buyers can take a loan and get tax benefit of up to rupees 1.5 lakh under Section 80EEB of the Income Tax Act. While these rates and schemes may differ to state by state, so it is important for you to refer the state incentives. So if you're planning to buy any electric vehicle, it is to tell you that all the EVs have been exempted from registration certificate fees in India. While for more information, you can log into india.com, and for more such videos, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.